we're going to use soft felt, ordinary cotton fabric, a needle and thread and a sewing machine, scissors, hooks and eyes, and small buttons or beads. You'll also need your figure for measurements. To make the pants, take your cotton fabric and place your doll on top. Then cut a long strip of fabric that is the width of your doll's height minus your doll's head. Fold and trim so that you have two rectangles of the same height. Fold over and hem both pieces to stop the fabric from fraying. If you're done hemming both pieces neatly, take your doll, fold your material, and make sure that the length of your folded material is longer than your doll's foot. Trim off excess fabric, then sew back and forth to finish the pant leg. If you're done sewing the pant legs closed, take one, open it up, then take the other and do the same. Then pair the two up, matching each end, and then sew down straight down the middle. When sewing this, you have to be extra careful not to sew the other side together. Okay, the back still open. After gently flipping the pants inside out, fold over the outer edge and hem so that you have a clean outline. This part is actually more easier to handle when hand sewn, but I wanted a cleaner edge, so I just used a sewing machine. Our pants is almost finished, although it looks very big, but don't worry, it's supposed to look like that. Using this pattern makes the waist awfully large for the doll, so we're going to adjust it by folding over a corner in the back, tucking it inside. Do this on both sides until the pants suits the doll. I've pinned both flaps in place to make it easier to sew. Using a needle and thread, I'm going to blanket stitch down, then connect, then come back up with a blanket stitch. I find using a blanket stitch is very fitting for edges to make them look better, then an in and over stitch to connect the two pant legs together, then come back out and go back up with a blanket stitch. Put it on the doll one last time, tugging it this way and that way to adjust the fitting. Then figure out where you're going to put your hook and eyes. I think this place will suit nicely. We've sewn on the hook and eyes. Now it's time to move up to the top. Making the top is really simple. Just take a coordinating color of soft felt, then take your doll, put it on the soft felt, and cut a long strip that's about the width of your doll's neck to your doll's thigh. I've cut my piece out and I gave it a slight curve to fit the neck part snugly. To cut out the armholes, I take the cloth, wrap it around the doll, then pinch where the shoulders are. Remove the doll, then using sharp fabric scissors, cut a small half circle out of the side. Open it up and repeat to make the other hole. Last but not least, take some tiny buttons and choose one that's a coordinating color, then sew it on the top corner of the garment. Voila! Here are the finished outfits. I can see a growing wardrobe now.